What's up, guys? I want to do a video entry into Gavkoo's knife contest, as well as give him an official shout out to everyone because he has an awesome knife channel, Gavkoo. Definitely take a look at this guy's videos. He's been making some really nice custom knives lately. Someone I've been subscribed to for a long time now, pretty well known within, you know, the tight circle of the knife community here on YouTube. It's weird, we have the knife community as a whole, then there's kind of like little cliques, just like high school. It's like these six guys always hang out together, and you know, those three guys are always talking together. It's that kind of a thing. But you know, if you haven't heard of him, definitely go check it out. He's making some really neat stuff, and I would be totally smitten if he were to make me a knife. So I'm entering into this contest. This is a design of knife that I came up with about a year ago. And I was tinkering around with some different ideas, and it's hard to come up with a new knife design that you haven't seen before, because there's really so many different knives out there. But this one was, I think, obviously inspired by one of my favorite, my all-time favorite slip joint patterns, the Texas toothpick. And obviously you'll see the influence in the design right here at the tail end. Okay, so ideally this knife would be about, you know, about life size, how it's printed on the paper. I want to say about 6 inches or so. That's average from what I hear. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Poor joke. Poor joke alert. So anyway, let's forget that just happened. And let's talk about the knife some more. Yeah, ideally it would be full tang. It's the only way to do it here. I think it is pretty darn sexy if you ask me. Really cool looking knife. Obviously that very acute tail end would be, you know, pretty impressive as far as defensive capability. Maybe that's your non-lethal option. You pull your knife and for whatever reason you don't want to go lethal, you just give a, you know, stab someone with that. It'll go in a little bit, but depending on what you do and where you do it, it might not be lethal. But it would certainly get your point across. I mean, you call it a skull crusher if you want to, if you want to feel cooler. But whatever. It's I think it's sexy looking. I really like the design, obviously. I came up with it. But I'm pretty versatile with a couple options. First off, on this example here, it's stainless steel pins or rivets that are hollow, okay? But I wouldn't be opposed to solid pins if that's something you'd want to do. I'd like to keep it stainless steel, you know, for the original design. As far as the handle scale, of course, you can go with any color you want. I just did black for an easy example. I like the idea of the scales to ride up on the blade itself. Again, something a little bit different, you know, over here coming up on the blade, and then again, kind of accenting the base here and letting that tang poke out and be nice and sharp there. Now, as far as the blade itself, I'm glad you do convex, because that's my original idea for this knife style, is to be a double-edged. I would like the swedge on the back to be completely sharpened, convex as well. And you can see the grind lines there. Pretty organic. I think it's pretty straightforward. I don't know all of your capabilities with the tools that you have or machinery, but I think it's quite possible. But I would like this fully double-edged if this is a design you're interested in doing, or if I happen to win the contest. Yeah, what else can I say about it? I do have two pretty deep finger choils on here. Now, as per the design, this is the overall look of it. Both of these finger choils can be morphed or moved for whatever was going to be most comfortable. If you made this exact same knife, it may not fit in your hand comfortably. Plus, there are very sharp corners on here, so perhaps the final design, you might want to soften this right here at this point and maybe bring this point down a little bit. This way it's more versatile for different size hands, and it will be more comfortable in more people's hands. All right, like I said, once you do a deeper finger choil like that, particularly two of them, like I want on this example, you're really narrowing yourself into, you know, one person's hand style and hand size. It could fit perfectly for one guy, another guy gets in his hand and it's total crap because they don't line up right, you know. So I would like the overall look to look like this, but of course, you know, being the knife maker you are and having your own ideas and stuff, certain things could be tweaked a little bit if it were to become an actual knife. But certainly softening up both these peaks here would be a very viable option. But that is all. Now, originally, I would like to have seen this with a black linen micarta handle. However, after seeing your recent videos and you doing that friction folder and then the fixed blade version in the, I think it was a bird's eye maple or maple burl. Wow. That is some sexy stuff. So I would love to see this knife done up just like this in that thick stock 154cm with some maple burl handle scales. And if you're going with maple burl, possibly some brass pins for it. Just depends. And of course the spacers would be, with the maple burl, I think it would look perfect with white spacers. That to me is an amazing, beautiful custom knife. So this is my entry into this, into your contest. I wish everyone who's entering, you know, the best of luck. And that's all. So this is a knife that will come alive. It's just a matter of time, whether I have to wait 15, 20 years to make it myself, because I'd love to get into knife making. You guys seen videos in the past probably. And occasionally I'll get a question like, you still trying to make your own knives? Well, I'd love to. I really do not have the time, nor do I have, you know, any of the machines I need or the place to do it. Nothing lines up like it should, you know. Without any money or time or place to do it, I really just can't do it. Can't make it happen right now. But it is definitely in my future, even if I have to wait until I retire. Before I die, I will make custom knives. That is my, you know, one of my life dreams and goals, is to be a knife maker. The thing is, not everyone can just make knives and make a living out of it. You know, a lot of times it becomes a hobby first, and then if you happen to become popular, then you can maybe make a living at it. But it's certainly a hard dream, you know, to succeed in. So anyway, that is all. That's my knife design. Hope you guys like it. Let me know what you think. Honest critiques. If you think it's an ugly piece of crap, let me know. But I think it's pretty sexy looking. So there it is, Gavkoo. Hope you like it. And that's all. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Appreciate it. Hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Take it easy.